Good evening, and welcome to our evening prayer on this wonderful evening. It's beautiful. The sunshine here, anyway, dappled through the trees as it hits the windows. Apologies, we start slightly late. A priest friend of mine rang at 5:15 to say his tyre was shredded. Could I rescue him from the tyre repair place and get him to Guildford Station? And those of you who know Guildford will know 5:15 is not the time to go from Slyfield to Guildford Station. Reminding me of that phrase that you hear, isn't it? Sort of, if you want to give God a laugh, tell him your plans. It's been that sort of day, that the various things I planned to do, overtaken by important events, sick calls, people at the door, preparing for a funeral, etc. You just find the not only is it not what you planned, but you find in hindsight that God somehow has a better plan and makes it work, and I'm here and we're praying together. As we begin, we acknowledge that we don't always have that confidence of God or of his action in our lives. We don't always have that attentiveness to hear him as clearly as we may hear those who ring and knock. And therefore, it's good to take this moment to hear his voice calling him, calling us rather, and to have that confidence of Mary in the way in which we respond. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. Come, praise the Lord, the Almighty, the King of all nations. Tell forth his fame, O you peoples, with loud acclamations. His love is sure, faithful his word shall endure, steadfast through all generations. Praise to the Father, most gracious, the Lord of creation. Praise to his Son, the Redeemer, who wrought our salvation. O heavenly dove, praise to thee, fruit of their love, giver of all consolation. Our eyes are turned to the Lord, we look for his mercy. To you have I lifted up my eyes, you who dwell in the heavens, my eyes like the eyes of slaves on the hand of their lords. Like the eyes of a servant on the hand of her mistress, so our eyes are on the Lord our God, till he show us his mercy. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy, we are filled with contempt. Indeed, all too full is our soul with the scorn of the rich, with the proud man's disdain. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our eyes are turned to the Lord. We look for his mercy. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. If the Lord had not been on our side, this is Israel's song, if the Lord had not been on our side when men rose against us, then they would have swallowed us alive when their anger was kindled. Then would the waters have engulfed us, the torrent gone over us, over our head would have swept the raging waters. Blessed be the Lord, who did not give us a prey to their teeth. Our life like a bird has escaped from the snare of the fowler. Indeed, the snare has been broken and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. God chose us in his Son and made us his adopted sons. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. He chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. He destined us in love to be his sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us. He has made known to us in all wisdom and insight the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ. His purpose he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. God chose us in his Son and made us his adopted sons. Brothers, do not slander one another. Anyone who slanders a brother or condemns him is speaking against the law and condemning the law. But if you condemn the law, you've stopped keeping it and become a judge over it. There is only one lawgiver, and he is the only judge and has power to acquit or to sentence. Who are you to give a verdict on your neighbor? Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. I said, Lord, have mercy on me. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Heal my soul, for I have sinned against you. My soul magnifies the Lord, since God has had regard for my humble state. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me, holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. My soul magnifies the Lord, since God has had regard for my humble state. The will of Christ is for all to be saved. Let us pray that his will may be done. Draw all to yourself, Lord. Lord, by your sacrifice on the cross, you redeemed us from the slavery of sin. Lead us to the freedom and glory of the children of God. Be with our Bishop Richard and all the bishops of your church. Grant them courage and compassion in their ministry. Help those who seek the truth to find it. Let them be consecrated in truth. We pray especially for peace in family life and for those orphaned and widowed. Comfort them in your love. May our departed brothers and sisters come to the heavenly city. There, with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you will reign forever. Carol asks that we might join with her in praying for Ollie. And Charmeline asks that we might offer prayers of thanksgiving for Roger, who, though still seriously ill, is beginning to show slight improvement, and to pray for his family who've been keeping vigil over him these last weeks. We pray too with Una, praying for the recovery of David, who was in hospital but is now back home. We pray for Cain, whose funeral is tomorrow morning. We pray for Carl Best, former seminarian for the diocese, whose funeral was this morning. Been quite a weekend. We give thanks for the confirmation candidates who've been confirmed on Saturday at the cathedral. And as we bid him farewell, we give thanks too for the ministry of Scott, who left this morning. We pray for Peter Black, whose funeral is this coming Wednesday, for Julia and for his family. We pray for the repose of the soul of Maureen Somerville. And we pray for all those to whom we have promised our intercession before the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. Lord God, it is our bounden duty to proclaim you as the light with whom there is no alteration or shadow of change. Enlighten our darkness as we reach the close of this day, and in your mercy forgive us our sin. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us thank you, as ever, for this time of prayer together. I think it's a wonderful wisdom in the church with the offices spread through the days, which cause us to pause and to pray, particularly like this office, because whereas the others might slide a bit and end up bunched up or perhaps more hurried than they should be, this is a fixed time, and in such a publicly fixed time, provides a wonderful little oasis in the middle of everything else that's happening, and indeed quite a lot that will be happening this evening. So it's wonderful to have paused in the presence of God and to be with you in prayer. May the Lord grant us a quiet night and a perfect end. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Evae. A te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes loquulos, et nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.